Hey y'all, check this out. Let me get straight to the point. I'm gonna delete these tracks right quick. All right, so I'm gonna drag this to the track, right? Let's say I wanna automate, or I wanna put an effect at a, you know, at a small clip on a track, right? All right, so now. So I'm gonna change the color of this right quick. Let me tell you, matter of fact, let me highlight this whole thing and so take the make it raw.
Now let me tell you people about this blackjack game.
Yeah,
it's caused me nothing but trouble.
All right, so now, say I want to put an effect and some automation on this specific part, right? All right, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to go get a delay, right? And what I'm going to do, I'm going to cut it off, right? I'm going to just press a simple button, press play.
Now, let me tell you people,
what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna just cut it on when it gets to this part right here.
It's caused me nothing right? But trouble, and I've only myself to blame. Hey, hey, hey.
Cut it off. Cut it back on. Whatever I wanna do. You know what I'm saying? So now I'm gonna go back. I'm gonna play that.
Now let me tell you, people, about this blackjack game. It's caused me nothing but trouble, and I've only myself to blame. Hey, hey,
so I'm cut off.
How unlucky can one man.
When I click this button, the automation is already drawn. It's already drawn on it, right? See, people, this what this do, this help you create your, it help you create all type of crazy effects and ideas, you know what I'm saying, real quick, without slowing your ideas and your process down to what you're trying to accomplish with your music, you know what I'm saying. And you know, because the difference with different people is, I'm gonna tell you the difference. One person might have an idea already what they want to put on their track. Another person might don't know what they trying to do. They don't know yet. So sometimes you just playing with something, you get the most craziest ideas. That happened with so many people in the studio, man. With making a beat, recording something, they playing around, they do something crazy, and they come up with a crazy idea by accident. Happens every time. So you don't want nothing to slow your creativity down. I'm gonna give you an example. This is why I say Bitwig automation is the best out of all the DAWs. I'm gonna tell you why. It's because of this right here. I'm gonna play it back. So what I'm gonna do, so the beat is gonna play, right? We're gonna press this again, simple as that.
Now let me tell you people about this blackjack game.
And what I'm gonna do when it come back on, I'm gonna just start tweaking knobs.
It's trouble, and I've only myself to blame. Hey, hey. How unlucky.
Right now, see, you see all these blue dots right here? All that's been automated already. You can go to each one of them. Click right here, hot cut, mix. Everything that I tweak. And if I want to just take it off, I could just right click and just press delete automation. Just like that, delete it out the way. And I still can go ahead and edit it and tweak it around the way I want to. So now I'm going to go back and play this.
Now let me tell you people about this blackjack game. It's caused me nothing but trouble, and I've only myself to blame.
Look at everything, come on. Everything about to turn.
How unlucky can one be?
You You could do this with just about any knob, even your mute buttons and your solo buttons. You could do this with any knob on this program, man. Pan buttons. And most DAWs, you can do the same thing, but it just, I'm going to show you the difference. All right, so now remember, I put the effect on the specific track. I put the effect only on this clip. So now let me close this. I'm open up Studio One. All right, I'm going to go get that same track, Blackjack.
Now let me tell you people about this blackjack game.
I'm going to turn this down so you can hear me a little bit.
Nothing but trouble.
All right, so now, let's say I'm going to close this mixer and I'm going to cut a specific part the same way. Make it a different color. All right, so now what I'm going to do, I'm going to go to my effects and go to delay, analog delay. I'll just grab this drum. And what you do, you hold alt. Hold on. You hold alt and you drag it. Simple. That's dope. That's dope. So now, before it used to be on the side. Let me see if it still is. Nah, it's not over there no more. So they got a new way where you click this little this FX button and got the groove delay. Dope. So now when you play it back.
Now let me tell you people about this blackjack game. It's caused me nothing but trouble, and I've only myself to blame. Hey, 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 yeah. How unlucky can one man be?
See, now the effect come in, which is good.
Well, every quarter I get.
All right, so now, what if I want to do automation, right? Okay. So now, the number one thing you have to do, you have to change this track into show automation, right? So if it's any one of these knobs I want to tweak, okay, remember, it's on this clip. If I press this button, you got to remember this change. So whatever button you press, the top part change. So if I want to do beat length, okay, I'm going to get something that's going to really affect the track. I'm going to do feedback. And when I drag and try to drop this, so I can do automation for that clip, I can't do nothing. Even if I go back and I press play, it don't even give me the option to write it. Right? So now I'm trying to, it won't let me do it that way, right? So by me putting the effect on there, I'm going to just have to press play.
How unlucky can one man be?
Just find the best way to tweak it.
Well, I can.
You know what I'm saying? And whatever I set, that's it. So that means that I can't do no automation. Okay, some people like to draw it in. I like to draw it in, but I like to use knobs because you could be more direct and more witty with it and more quick with it. Turning knobs. You know what I'm saying? As you're going with your flow. But everybody's work ethic is different. But with me, I tweak them knobs up. And then if I make a little small mistake, and it's something that I need to tweak up, then I go back to the track and then, you know, start moving the automation stuff around. So check this out. So now, we already know that you can't do damn automation on this part when it's on a clip. All right, so what I'm going to do, hold on. That plugin got to be over here somewhere because you should better take it off. It used to be on this side, man. Maybe I'm all in the wrong place, man. Hold up. There you go. That's right here. So I'm gonna take that, remove that. I'm gonna take it off. All right. So what you have to do, you have to get it and drop it on a, completely on the track, right? Now, open that back up. So now, if I want to automate this specific part right here, the question is, can I press the power button? If you notice, if I press the power button, it don't pop up here for me to automate it. So I can't automate the power button. Now, I can automate that because it pops up here, right? Because the important thing about it, I want to automate the power button so I can turn it on when it gets to this part. Since I can't do automation on this specific clip. So that's corny. You know what I'm saying? So, all right. Now you see what I'm saying? Me trying to figure out, trying to do all this, this slowing my creativity down of what I'm trying to accomplish. And that's my point. You know what I'm saying? What I like about Bitwig when it comes to certain things. Especially if you're a person been using a lot of DAWs for a long time anyway. You get what I'm saying? Studio One's still great. Don't get it messed up. But, you know, it's certain. You got to ask yourself what's very important with you when you're doing music. And with me, it's workflow, automation. You know what I'm saying? Mixing, comping. You know what I'm saying? Main thing is workflow. To get things out real quick. You know what I'm saying? Without... I mean, instead of sitting there trying to figure out what the hell you need to, you know, what you're trying to do. But anyway, so if I want to, you know, automate this, I get it and I drag it to the next track, or I can drag it on the track. It's two different ways. Then what I have to do next, I have to sit here and press right. Now, once I press right, I press play. Now if I want to tweak another button, it's not going to do anything right then and there. It won't let me tweak nothing else. You know, to automate. See, by me moving the other buttons, it's only right in this one because I had to drop down. So now I have to go to feed, click on feedback, get it, and drop it on this track. And then go back. Keep right on. Press play and change this. Let me tell you people about this. You get what I'm saying? Now, if I just want to change this knob right here, it's not going to let me do it. It won't let me do it. So now I can go to each one of them. You know, I can still look at it like, you know, in Bitwig the same way. But now if I want to do this track, I got to go right here and I can drop it. Add another track like this if I want to, and I gotta press right. Now what I gotta do now, I gotta put read on that one. No, put read on this one. Oh, that's a global. Hold on. That's a global feedback. Drag another one.
Now let me tell you people.
And then now for me to write this one, press play.
Now let me tell you people.
You get what I'm saying? So now I'm sitting here trying to, I gotta sit and do automation on each one of these. Now, in order for me to play these back, I gotta go to write, and then I gotta go to read. For it to read what the hell I just drawn. You know what I'm saying?
Let me tell you people.
See, but as you can see in Bitwig, I just press one button to tweak what the hell I want to tweak, go back and press play. That's the difference. And people, what people have to understand is this. This slows your creativity. It took me that long to get that out. Like, I remember how to do it a little bit, but at the same time, you got to do all this extra shit just to tweak, you know, some basic knobs. Because sometimes, like I tell you, Some people already know what they want to do, and some don't know what idea they about to put on their track. And sometimes you come up with the best ideas by just tweaking random shit, making mistakes. And I work both ways. When I'm recording people, when I'm doing sampling, when I'm chopping up samples. You get what I'm saying? So, like I say, you have to ask what you think and what's better for you. This show, Krizzle, subscribe. I'm going to be doing, like, you know, other videos for, you know, Bitwig versus Studio One. And I'm going to be specific with, I'm going to do, each video is going to be only focusing on one thing. Instead of putting everything in one video, it's going to focus on one thing. Peace.